My name is Jessica Luana Oliveira, and I would like to welcome you all to my thesis presentation entitled Assessment of Habitats and Species of Conservation Interest to support the MPA implementation process in the Tyrrhenian Sea with a focus on Cintrocephalon longispinus. Before we start, I would like to inform you that the work was divided into two main chapters. The chapter number one was based in the first research question, which marine habitats are present in the area that can support the establishment of MPA. And the chapter number two focuses on the sea urchin Cintrocephalon longispinus based on the research question among protected species, which one could be valorized to highlight the peculiar marine biodiversity of the area. So due to the time limit of this presentation, I have chosen to present on the chapter one, since it brings the main concept of this thesis by providing the assessment of local biodiversity and will better support the MPA implementation process, as well as provide some tools to improve the uniqueness of the area. So marine protected areas are defined by USN as a locality's design based on pre-settled objectives for long-term protection of the marine ecosystems, management of human activities, and attention to the local demands. It's understandable that the feasibility of the implementing and managing these areas depend on three major pillars: the socio-economic aspects, biological features, and political interests. Additionally, it's essential to understand the role of human interaction in this process, since the user groups and stakeholders are directly included in the planning and management, and they will also make the success be possible. Some studies suggest that an MPA success or failure is most significantly influenced by the presence or an absence of stakeholder engagement, which has seemed to be the most significant component in both situations. So, according to the Italian laws, MPA are defined and have a similar definition as presented by USN. And the area of the interest of this study was Aeolian Archipelago, that is considered by a ministerial decree as a potential protected area due to oceanographic, volcanic, and biological features. This area is also a UNESCO World Heritage, which, although well-defined for terrestrial characteristics, is still ambiguous regarding marine characteristics. So one of the seven islands in this archipelago, named Island of Salina, it's considered the second biggest island in the archipelago and presents distinct marine habitat types that have been considered with scientific importance. So few studies on this ecological potential have been carried out for this area, and that's why new complementary studies are important to bring more scientific knowledge on the area and support the implementation process. Besides, it's important to have this point of connection to enhance the chances of creating an MPA network in Italian waters and improve the conservation of marine resources. Then, the aim of this study were to increase knowledge about protected habitats and species and to enhance conservation by proposing a feasible conservation planning through compiled data regarding traits, biological, and social features. So, five dive sites around Salina Island with similar conditions for temperature and depth range were assessed for four divers on September last year. The sampling methods were based on underwater visual sensors and the reef check protocol for the Mediterranean Sea that provide information about habitats and species except for fishes. And by my supervisor, expert assistance, and personal communication, the third aspect regarding human activities and impact was also included. So data analysis were carried out for these aspects, such as beta diversity in our software and hierarchical clusters in past software. So from the results of this analysis, ideas and suggestions were given for the zonation. And to present the results, I'm going to follow the numbering sequence of habitats, species, and human activities. So first, the habitat description and protection level. The habitat type description is crucial for understanding the presence and abundance of species in each site. And because of that, the habitats from Reef Check Manual, the Reef Check Protocol, were broken down into the priorities habitats present in the Italy reference, by the document of the SPA-BU protocol, the Barcelona Convention. And the description based on Barcelona Convention bring a more consolidated information regarding the habitat, such as characterizing species, sensitivity to specific disturbances, nature of substratum, etc. Even though Lettre Pietri presented a different description of the habitat when following the priority habitat list, it was considered as important as Scoglio Calcato because to the zonation proposal, because of the high abundance of Posidonia oceanica in the area, and also to enhance the value of Posidonia as an ecosystem services provider. Regarding taxa characterization and community composition, a total of 22 species were identified in the study, as you can see in the table, where the values of richness by location are similar, oscillating around 12, which with the highest number found in Scoglio Calcato, that was 14. Of all 22 species, 12 species recognized during underwater activities comes from the reef check protocol, the ones with the red stars, while another 10 species are not included in the reef check so far. The importance of considering these extra 10 species is due to relevant reasons such as Pinna rudis and Cystoseira, a species included in the Barcelona Convention, and Allophilus petulacea, a non-indigenous species for the Mediterranean Sea. From these 22 taxa by international law, and 6 species are included in the USN Red List. So these 5 species that I'm highlighting now were registered in all sites, where we can see also in the center of the Venn diagram. Except for Faraglione di Polara, all the other 4 sites showed exclusivity in the presence of some species, a total of 7 species that I just highlight now. So the biodiversity index, the another analysis used for this study, through the nestness and turnover particularities, shows the change of species along an environmental gradient. For example, a variation among the sites. So the species composition revealed occasional variations where certain taxa appears in only one site, which causes a high beta diversity value. As you can see, beta number 1, the general value for the Salina Island. And even though the lowest beta diversity, for example, in beta number 3 for Faraglione di Polara and Lettre Pietri, and beta number 7 for Grotta dei Gamberi and Scoglio Calcato, the value of turnover goes higher than the nesting value, which means that these areas are not sub-area of each other. Following this logic, all sites assessed cannot be considered a sub-area of another area. Then, each site presents their uniqueness with regards to the species composition. So, to find out how the sites are grouped according to the presence of species, the hierarchical cluster was created, and thus the division into two main groups. The first an isolated circle del capo, and the other 2 clusters where they show greater proximity, the Lettre Pietri Faraglione di Polara and the Grotta dei Gamberi and Scoglio Calcato. Through this analysis, it's also possible to observe the grouping of the species and the dendrogram on the top right. This organization occurs due to the frequency with which these species are found in the sampling sites. When they are found grouped, their species on the sites was exactly the same. What can be observed for beta and cluster diversity is that those places that present the lowest beta diversity rate, as I said before, beta number 3 and beta number 7, are the most similar in the group. So regarding anthropogenic impacts, a total of 4 human activities were considered, such as diving, fishing, plastic litter, and unregulated anchoring. All activities appear in the 5 locations. And the Lettre Pietri is the site that shows the lowest anthropogenic impact. So, for example, for the diving factor, which depends on the season, the activities registered were scuba diving and spear fishing. Regarding fishing, the activities were divided into recreational, professional, and unregulated trawling. Remember that the trawling, in the way that is happening now, is illegal because should be done 3 nautical miles away from the coast, and should not be done on post-donor cyanica middles. So regarding plastic litter, the remains of the plastic litter comes from fishing activities. So most of them, the remains are lines, nets, or artificial baits. And the regulated anchoring is carried out by recreational boats, free divers, and diving centers. So the Iroquois cluster shows the distance between the localities based on the human activities, where Letra Pietra appears as the most isolated site because of the lower human pressure recorded for this area. On the other hand, Grotta de Gamberi and Scolgo Caccato shows the shortest distance, which could be explained by the similar traits and its intensities in these locations. So for the zonation proposal, according to this result presents, the intensity of each category that I just speak about in each site was plotted on the map, followed by species importance, habitat priority, and anthropogenic impact. So based on those, the suggestion is that a small and symbolic zone A could be defined focused on the presence of post-donor cyanica, as you can see in the light blue color, the forest of Cistozera on the red, and the marine cave observed during field activities but not reported so far on red color. The implementation of zone A must take into account the avoidance of conflicts with local interests, and the zone B is a general reserve that could be implemented all around the island, changing tourists a fee and limiting the uptake of marine natural resources. A table with the activities allowed and forbidden is attached to the proposal in order to clarify points for the implementation process. So for instance, the scientific dive is the only activity allowed for the zone A, while the suggestion for zone B is to allow some activities for residents who document an historical background in the area. So in conclusion, the current study brought a unique take on the Salina Island, located in the Tyrrhenian Sea, by bringing additional ecological data and a compiled socioeconomic view displayed on a zonation proposal map. So in addition to all the ecological data carried out in this study, it's completely understandable the need of constant monitoring of this area, also consider all the factors for a better understanding of the dynamics that occurs in the area. Besides, it's understandable that a clear study in fish ecology, top predators, and currents can add a great value to the understanding of the area. And the more consolidated research that goes into the MPA implementation, the better will be to successfully apply the next step for this operation. So now I would like to thank my promoter Carlo Cerano and my supervisor Giulia Bernardi for giving me the opportunity to carry out my master thesis on this project, and also for being extremely supportive throughout it. And thanks to the Blue Marine Foundation to support us during the monitoring in Salina Island on September. And thanks to Mark Polytechnica University, Ghent University, and IMBSC program for giving the opportunity to carry out this master's degree. And thank you for your attention. And it's a pleasure to answer any of your questions.